I want to keep this short and sweet for those of you that don't know me. My name is Joshua Chadwick, and I represent the class of 2022 as class president and today's salutatorian. I would like to formally welcome you to our class's graduation ceremony. Everybody graduated, so that deserves a round of applause. I remember playing Pomp and Circumstance, except for the class of 2020 for reasons we know, but I really appreciate all these student volunteers coming out to play for us. Our whole class really appreciates it. We mostly kept in time. I mean, like, I was looking at everyone's feet, and we were all kind of, yeah, we stayed on beat pretty good. It's crazy to think that it's our turn to be up here in these stands. Last year, after they finished graduation, I was like, whoa, next year it's our turn. And now it is. It's something else. COVID wasn't super enjoyable, but other than that, I mean, like, this whole high school career has been really exciting. There's been a lot going on. The senior year definitely made up for it. I know that personally, and I hope that all of our seniors here had a great senior year as well. It's funny to think about, like, I think 4 years ago, yeah, 8th grade move up, I was on stage up there in the cafeteria giving a speech on, like, how some of our classmates thought it'd be funny to, like, run into a car and get it, and how I was hopeful that we would all have, like, really good high school experience. So, I think we've all proved ourselves worthy of that praise, and proved to the school that we're a pretty good class. I think will be remembered for a long time. Our contributions to the school in academics, sports, and other extracurriculars have not gone unnoticed, and I hope that our class's legacy lives on in the Naselle community years after we continue on into our next journeys. All right, so I'm gonna cut to the chase. This class is pretty fantastic. But I wanna make sure that all the parents and grandparents, at least the parents, understand that this is your work. We are the product of our teachers and our parents. So please, while you watch your child receive the diploma today, and hopefully some scholarships and stuff, take note of all of those years of work you put in to help us get where we are today. Thank you and welcome.
I'll miss the underclassmen and being able to watch the elementary students. is learning to be supportive as much as I have been supported here. This year, the staff and community of Naselle tried to revive what we lost and give the class of 2022 an incredible senior year. Support through clubs, sports, and fundraisers provided us with the resources to make our senior year memorable. My class proved that the heart and grit of Naselle could get us anywhere. Some trophies and a couple state championships later, the athletes sitting behind me made sure that no one would pronounce it as Naselle ever again. Not only did baseball put us on the map, but just last week, our robotics team competed in Maryland and made sure that this small town in southwestern Washington would be known on national level. To the class of 2023, I expect you to be here at 7 a.m. sharp tomorrow to play in the gym. For you future seniors, I will leave you with these words. Wear the comet with pride. Be honest and do not let anyone make you feel lesser, even if your goals and dreams are different. Don't waver from your beliefs and explore the opinions of those outside your circle. Graciously take the community's support and use it to your advantage. Leave high school optimistic for your future and grateful for your experiences, good and bad. The world is so much bigger than Naselle. The sooner you realize this, the sooner you can appreciate what makes Naselle, Washington so special. Thank you to my parents, who never made me feel like I had to prove myself worth, but who encouraged me to be my own person, no matter what that looked like. My classmates and I have been so lucky to have the support from the staff and community, who I'd like to say thank you to. Thank you for making our senior year as normal as possible. Thank you for taking the time to build relationships with our students. Thank you for understanding and helping us find different paths we will go on after graduation. Thank you for believing in us. The best goodbyes are never easy, so thank you, Naselle, Grade River Valley School, and the class of 2022 for making this goodbye so hard.
Compassion and empathy that this class has shown not only their friends, but also their students, but also other students and staff is unmatched. I am so proud of the amazing young adults you have all become. So I'm going to shift the podium just a bit. Don't worry, I won't point it back to anybody. But other than Albert, I want to talk directly to the class of 2022. I want to give you guys all one last lecture. This lecture will not be about periodic table. I know. Or Newton's laws, or the powerhouse of the cell. But Ryan, real quick, what's that called? Thank you. Okay, I want to leave you all with just a little bit of advice to stay with you as you navigate the roller coaster that is life. I hope that in your darkest days, you will remember my words, and you will remember how much I, as well as the rest of the staff here, care about each and every one of you. I've been a teacher for 8 years now. Through the years, I have witnessed student successes as well as failures. There have been A's earned, championships won, relationships formed, high notes hit, and many more. I have also observed the failures and the angst that come with them. High school has been a safe environment for you to experience both the highs and the lows. You have had a community of people around you to cheer you on and also ready to catch you when you fall. You are going to enter a world where hard things will happen to you. There will be jobs you won't get, relationships that don't last, and mistakes made. I want to take a moment to talk about the mistakes. You're going to make big ones. You're going to make lots of small ones. We all make them. All of the mistakes that I have made, big and small, led me to the life that I have, the life that I love. There will come times in your life when you will feel lost. I want you to remember that within that lostness, you also have the opportunity to be found. Do not, under any circumstance, let the moments in your life that are less than ideal write the pages of your life. Use these moments as a springboard to a better future. Use these experiences as a chance to learn about yourself and what you want out of life. Your failures or your mistakes will teach you more than your successes, because they will force you to grow. They will force you to evaluate your life and figure out what is not working. I think many students in high school with the thought that they have to know their path. There is generally a look of panic and an exasperated, I don't know, response from many juniors and seniors when I ask the question, what are your plans? That is okay. It is fine to not have your entire life planned out. In my opinion, it's actually better. You're going to change so much as you leave the hallways of Naselle High School. Many of you are going to change your path more than once. There is a quote that says, edit your life frequently and ruthlessly. It's your masterpiece after all. If you're not happy with any aspect of your life, change it. Do something about it. You guys have the power and the skills to do so. Many of you have heard the story that I'm about to tell you. Ever since I was a young girl, I dreamed of being a marine biologist. I really think I just had visions of swimming with whales and dolphins in Hawaii. I completed a summer internship working as a lab technician for professors at the University of Washington. It was a great opportunity, and I'm really thankful for what I learned. I think the most important thing that I learned was that I didn't want to pursue this career. Marine biology would have led to a career that involved a lot of solitary work. I learned that I enjoy being around people, and I thrive in the interactions I have with them. So I edited my path. I chose to finish my degree in biology and pursue my master's in teaching. That is what led me here. This was not a failure, just a change in direction. Don't ever think you are stuck because you start something. Always have the option to take a detour to a different, better path for you. I have been fortunate throughout my life to have a solid foundation of people who support me. Find those people and hold on tight. During the difficult times in your life, it is important to have a community to support you. These are the people that will answer the phone at 3 o'clock in the morning. The people who will listen without an agenda. And the people who will make time for you even when they have their own busy lives. Choose to surround yourself with people that encourage you to follow your dreams, no matter how crazy those dreams might be. There is a song by Eric Church that has lyrics that say, "Don't let fear steal your brain. Don't let the fear of failing prevent you from doing the brave things in life. Oftentimes, the things that scare you the most are what you should be doing. Be brave enough to choose a career that makes you excited to go to work. Be brave enough to pursue the relationships that challenge you. Be brave enough to travel to the places that take your breath away. Do not settle for safe things in life when there's a voice in your head telling you that you are capable of doing more. I have spent the last 6 years telling each of you that you are capable of achieving whatever your vision of success is. As this is the last time, I will speak to you together as one group. That's not your job. You need to tell yourself each and every day that you have the power to achieve any dreams you have. And remember, if there are speed bumps or detours along the way, you will be fine. You will persevere. You will find a way to move forward. If you ever need me to remind you how much potential you have, you know where to find you. I hope you all have the courage to find your happiness. I hope you find the things that your soul craves. I hope you believe that you are capable and deserving of curating the life that you want. I hope you never let the ease and comfort of standing still prevent you from chasing your happiness. I hope you use your missteps to learn and to look ahead and not to look backwards. I hope you fight for the life that you want, and I hope you show the world what I know each and every one of you are capable of achieving. To end, I would like to share the words that your other teachers use to describe you when asked. They include dynamic, kind, good-natured, honest, spirited, eclectic, sociable, adventurous, creative, intelligent, independent, self-aware, law teachers, courageous, and contributors. That sounds like a pretty amazing class, a pretty amazing group of people we are sending out into the world. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you. remain standing and then ask the following five students to please join in the standing. So those five students are Riley Orson, Courtney Paul, Abu Sensi, Peyton Dalton, and Joey Strange. These seven students have achieved high honors, and this honor is reserved for students who have earned a cumulative grade point average of 3.75 and above, and they're further distinguished by the gold cords hanging around their necks. Great job. And then there are seven other students who have earned cumulative grade point averages between 3.2 and 3.74. And they're distinguished by the silver cords hanging around their necks, and I'd like to ask them to briefly stand as I announce their names. Those students are Ryan Walton-Pate, Theron Frame, Mia Watson, Jack DeCastino, Orlando Salazar Flores, Morgan Ritz, and Haley Lopez. At this point, we'd like to recognize several students who received special honors and awards this last week at our Youth of Excellence. So as I announce your names, please also stand so that you can be recognized. So the following nine students earned departmental honors in the following subject areas for their performance in these respective areas. And in many cases, it was for their cumulative performance over the last 4 years. So for English, Aaron Frame. For social studies, Ryan Walton-Pate and Peter Dalton. So please stand. For mathematics, Josh Chadwick. For science, Grace Hunt. For health and fitness, Joey Strange and Jane Bradley. For career and technical education, Orlando Salazar Flores. And for fine performing arts, Jack DeCastino.
$1,000 scholarship from the Bayshore Animal Hospital,
The Ralph and Marie Gallon Wood Scholarship, the amount of $500. Finnish American Folk Festival Scholarship, in the amount of $500. And then a scholarship in the amount of $1,500 from the Friends of the World Foundation Wildlife Foundation. And lastly, she will receive a $15,000 per year Western Undergraduate Exchange Scholarship through the Oregon State University, which will total $60,000 over 4 years. Great job.
Congratulations.
Kroll. Courtney will receive $2,500 in local scholarships. She'll receive a $1,000 Ron Moore Memorial Scholarship and a $1,000 Jacob and Wilhelmina Patton Memorial Scholarship, and then also a $500 Jerry Tommy Gallup Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations.
$77,000 for her higher education training through the Montgomery GI Bill. Congratulations.
for Centralia Community College, you should receive an athletic scholarship that covers any costs that were not already covered by other financial aid scholarships. So congratulations and good luck. Here. That concludes the scholarships and awards portion of this graduation ceremony. And I just want to say how proud we are of these graduates and their many achievements, and wish every one of them the best of luck. And I just want to make just a couple quick comments about these guys. As you've heard from the other speakers today, we all consider this to be a very special and remarkable group of students. And I just want to say how proud I am of them. Like the rest of us, this group has faced a number of tremendous challenges and uncertainty during this last 2 years, and they've lost a lot. Again, they have maintained positive attitudes and provided tremendous leadership in our school and community. Many of them are serving in our Big Brothers and Big Sisters program. They've been supporting our elementary and middle school students in various other ways, serving as TAs, helping out at PE, lunch, recess, and working with some of our highest need students. And they've been great role models. And as you've heard during this ceremony, you can see reflected on that table, this is a tremendous high achiever. There are a number of outstanding students who have earned academic honors and distinctions. There's exceptional athletes who earn individual team honors. That includes several state appearances and places in all sports. There's multiple state champions in this group, and two who won their college sports. There are multiple students who participated in an international robotics competition in Maryland last week, and they earned second place for their engineering design and technical design.
Peyton Heidi Dole.
Kieran James Brain. Jason Wayne Harmon. Nicole Sherry Hopkins.
Thank you. High School District, it gives me great honor and pleasure to certify that the students standing behind me this evening have not only met the requirements of the state of Washington, but also the specific standards as set forth by this school district. And after their countless hours of study, preparation, testing, and community service, it is my great pleasure to announce to you the graduating class of 2022.